Welcome back to Breakfast. Easter is just over a month away, which means we can definitely start eating hot cross buns now. I've been doing it since January, to be honest. But where can you go to get the best one in the country? Lachie McLeod has the exclusive announcement of the winner of New Zealand's Great Hot Cross Bun competition. Lachie, who is it?
Well, Daniel, I can tell you, after work you can pop on down because it's daily bread here in Brito Mart. Congratulations. Let's get the trophy over. Hand the trophy.
Congratulations again.
Amazing.
Three times in a row.
Patrick, three times in a row.
Oh my God.
Amazing.
It's such a great feeling. Thank you so much. And I believe it's the first time that a bakery won three times in raw best hot cross buns in New Zealand. So I would say it's a hat-trick, eh?
Hat-trick. Did you expect when you entered this year that you would go three times?
To be honest, yes.
You were that confident that they were that good. Yeah. It was easy.
Yeah, and it wasn't easy, definitely not. I would say it was the hardest we ever did. But yeah, I want to say a special thanks to Sid, my pastry baker. We did it together. Give me a high five, bro. He will tell you more about the hot cross buns shortly. And special thanks to my business partner, Josh, and my wife, Moni, for your constant support. Thanks to the Complete Daily Bread team. I love you all. And thanks to my friends, Karen, Amy, and Scott Parker, who picked me up and dropped me off to the competition. Amy, without you, I couldn't do it.
Well, congratulations, Patrick. Thank you. Mentioned Sid, one of the men behind the hot cross bun. How proud are you to go three in a row?
I'm super proud. I'm feeling super happy as well.
And tell me a little bit about what goes into making this hot cross bun so good.
The buns are made using sourdough, which keeps them nice and fluffy in texture. And the spice mix which we are using is a homemade blend, which is a secret recipe. The fruits which we use to soak the hot cross buns is soaked in pineapple rum, which is from Bay of Islands, which gives a nice and tropical flavor and a kick.
And now tell me, I've always wondered, the cross, what's that made out of?
That's also another secret.
I tried, but not even a hint.
Some flour.
No. Some flour. Now, Bernie, I want to bring you in here, because you're a big part of this. Three times.
Baking New Zealand is a big part of supporting the bakers and our members, and we're very proud of all our members, and especially these guys here. The judging was tough, but these guys still had the outstanding bun on the day. There's three judges, and they all work on an app. I wasn't a judge because I'm the president, but I could see the winners straight away. You know, it's great to see the result ended up to be what it should have been. Yeah.
Now I've got people in my ear telling me we need to bring them back, some back to the team at TVNZ.
Yes.
Have you tried them? What makes them so good?
Well, I think it's nearly a 30-hour fermentation. Is it, Patrick, about that?
It's our fermentation, it's the processes, and of course the passion of the team.
The passion of the team.
Every part is a key ingredient to the best bun. Yeah, the team is very important too, isn't it? They've got a great passionate team, but that's led by the leaders and the owners as well too. You know, you only get a good team, you only get out what you put in.
Well, guys, thank you so much for joining me this morning. Congratulations, third year. Daniel, we've got a few tips for you, mate, for this Friday when you're doing the staff shout and bringing in your hot cross buns. I look forward to it.
Right, the pressure is on.
I'm looking forward to you coming back with those hot cross buns so that we can...
Patrick, I tell you, forget the BAFTAs. He's just given a great speech.
I know.
I mean, it's gorgeous. All about the people. But like me, Patrick, you know, you try and lead the team.
Okay, on that note, we've got to go.